breath we bit and grimly wait. Robbery expert, a debt in homicide.
We seize the cash of strangers rash.
We seize the cash of strangers rash.
It is a blind
our feet upon the mountain path are silent as the rabbits. The government regards with wrath our kleptomaniac habits. But what care we for government?
Why not on Tinker's Gamlet?
But what care we for government?
Why not on Tinker's Gamlet?
Our captain's name has dreadful fame in many a town and hamlet. Our captain's name has dreadful fame. Ha like this, with beetle brows profound, look left, look right, with shaded sight, and listen at the ground. So loud and cow like this, and clap your carbines burn, will crush at once the stupid dud who speaks above a murmur.
Today.
Gentlemen, have I not told you?
There's never a traveller comes our way but trembles to hear our name. And anyone dares to say us nay quickly finds me ashore of aim. Oh, our step it is light on a mountain path as we lurk in the bush unseen. Oh, and we take all the cash a traveller hath by the force of a carbine keen. Oh,
that's all.
That's all.
Answers to your call, pip-pap. On you wind it if you answers when it sweeps, pip-pap. There's a flash and a spark in the dark, oh dark, and a voice from the bow unseen. Here's a friend that always answers to your call, pip-pap. On you wind it if you answers when it sweeps, pip-pap. Oh, the dark, your king is a helpless thing. Who faces my carbine keen?
It always answers at the call.
Hip-hop!
Oh, and if you answer when it hits,
hip-hop!
Oh, the Tartar King is a helpless thing. Who faces my carbine keen?
But a truce to vocal bravado. Fellow stockholders of the Royal Madrid Brigands Association, as president of this syndicate, I hereby call this meeting to order. Now, what's the first business to be brought before the board of directors?
There is the ongoing matter to consider the moving of our headquarters away from the shadow of this accursed castle. The constant shrieks of the blood-red demon who haunts yon high tower are keeping the stockholders awake at night.
Ah, 'tis not but the ghost of the noble Don who slew his fair but faithless bride, and then took his own life. Oh, the thought of such an apparition does nicely to keep all regular folk away. But to calm all fears, this is a very interesting story.